in the Wye Valley area, the hills are truly alive with the sound of motor caravanners lacing up their walking boots. However, I haven't got time for a leisurely stroll as I'm off to find my campsite, which is just a short drive away from here.
The site I've chosen is in the heart of the Wye Valley, surrounded by countryside. Around every corner is a new and beautiful view, which reveals itself in all its glory as you approach Blackmoor Camping and Caravanning Club site.
I've chosen to stay here at Blackmoor Camping and Caravanning Club site. It's close to all the attractions that I want to visit, and it's a beautiful, quiet place to relax.
Market towns are dotted throughout the area and invite the holidaymaker to spend time browsing the little shops and exploring hidden gems. Upton-upon-Severn is the nearest sizeable town to the site, and I'm heading there now.
I've just arrived here in Upton, which is just a short way away from the campsite. If you want to take the bus, there's one runs every hour, or you can actually bring your motor home here with a car park where you can park just around the corner. But I'm here to check out the boat cruises with Severn Leisure Cruises. There's plenty of cruises to choose from, with day trips to both Worcester and Tewkesbury. The day trip to Worcester will take you about 2 hours 45 minutes, so you'll be on the boat for a lot of the day. It's worth noting that when you get there, there's plenty to see and do. There's also regular dinner dine cruises, and should you like a bit of music, there's also swing and blues. So why don't you check the website and find out what else they have to offer. I'm off now to take my own trip. It's a beautiful sunny day here today, so what better way to enjoy it than to be sat here on the deck? And if you fancy it, why not head downstairs to the Wells Docks Bar where you can get yourself a drink? But until then, why not just sit back, relax and take in the view? I've just arrived here in Tewkesbury and just walked off the boat. This is a great place to explore, but one of the first places I want to visit is the Abbey. I'm off there to meet someone who can tell me a little more about it.
On the way to the Abbey, you'll pass antique shops, cafes, quirky tea rooms, cobbled streets and historic houses. Tewkesbury has a medieval feel, and you can imagine that despite modernisation, the town hasn't changed that much. The outside of the Abbey is spectacular, imposing even. It attracts tourists from all over the world. But what secrets does it hold, and why is it important to the townspeople? Philippa Shaw, Executive Officer of the Abbey, explains.
We're sitting in the choir at Tewkesbury Abbey. The Abbey was founded in just after 1100 and consecrated in 1121. So in 2021, we're going to be celebrating the 900th anniversary of the consecration of the Abbey. This is one of the earliest parts of the Abbey to be built. The Abbey is longer than 13 of the UK's cathedrals and almost the biggest parish church in the UK. If we still had the Lady Chapel built on the East End, we'd be longer than Beverley Minster, and then we would be the longest parish church in the UK. Tewkesbury Abbey was very involved in the Wars of the Roses, and in 1471 the Battle of Tewkesbury took place just down the road from here. Some of the soldiers on the Lancastrian side took refuge in the Abbey and were dragged out by the Yorkists and slaughtered. The Abbey was then closed for 4 years before it was reconsecrated and had to be reopened again. There were 5 bishops and a big service to reconsecrate it before it could be used for church services again.
Who'd have thought that the Abbey had so many stories to tell? I'd thoroughly recommend a visit, but after catching the return boat back to Upton, I was on my way back to the campsite.
It's been a great day for exploring, but I'm really glad to get back here on the site and do some relaxing. There's so much to see and do just on the site alone, so why not join me later on and I'll show you around.